6th of April 2018, Norfolk Broads Direct. The Admiral is back on the Broads. So cue the music, roll the credits, and let's start another great adventure. Yeah! I'm back, absolutely. How are you doing? Back on the Broads once again. The Admiral returns for 2018 for the first of what will be an epic year out on the Broads. Today I'm starting at Norfolk Broads Direct. I have hired Fare Executive 2 for 7 nights out and about, and I'm looking really, really forward to it. I have been wanting to hire, well, not particularly executive, it was more Jubilee. I've been wanting to hire Fare Jubilee for quite a number of years now. But I've ended up with executive, which is the exact same as Fare Jubilee, bar one small detail, which is why I've ended up with executive and not Jubilee, but I'll come back to that later. It is a wee bit, unfortunately, cloudy. Wee bit of a breeze sort of picking up slightly, but it's not too cold at the moment. The weather, unfortunately, is not looking to be the best, and I have no idea where I'm putting cameras at the moment, but this is going to be brilliant. It feels so, so good to be back here. The time is only about 1 o'clock on a Saturday afternoon, and I've already got the boat. Unpacked, all organised. I can't believe how quick it was today. I walked into reception and the boat was ready, and I got the boat straight away, and it was just like, right, just whenever you're ready to go. And it was like, oh, I've not even done any shopping yet. So I'm about to go and just get all my life jackets and everything like that, and go and do a wee bit of shopping, and then it's down the river, and I've no idea what will happen this time, but it feels so great to be back here, and I'm looking forward to what I'm sure will be another wonderful, great adventure once more out on the Broads. That's all for now. Just very, very quickly, say hi, and I'm going to finish getting myself organised, get back out on the rivers, and see where the day takes us. So until later, until I've got something more to update with you, I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now. Cheers. once again on the river. Oh my god, this is so good. It's really quite surprising, actually, you know. It's only been like 6 months or something since my last adventure, and I've been so missing it, you know, being back down here in the rivers. And oh, it just feels, I've literally just left the boatyard. You know, you can probably see Bernd Brinkcraft passing by me in the background, and it feels so fantastic to be here already, you know. Really, really is brilliant. So, loving being back on the Broads. I've no idea where I'm going at the moment. So I'm just literally cruising down the river, leaving Wroxham, getting myself all organised, getting myself all sort of excited, and just figuring out what it is we are going to do and where I am going to go. So far, I am loving this fair executive. She seems to be quite comfortable, actually, very luxurious inside, I must admit, you know. All the wee gadgets and the mod cones, you know, I do like my little luxuries, you know. So I had a wee bit late in leaving the boatyard. Obviously I had to go away and do a wee bit of shopping, which promptly came away back to the boat, put everything away, and probably forgot some stuff that I actually really needed. So, but rather than go back, I'll pick that up later. I had to get the engineer out because I tried to tune in the radio, and the radio wasn't working, you know, so obviously a fault had developed with that. But quick wee word with an engineer and a whole new head unit change, probably about, 10 minutes or something like that. And that's it. So we are on our way, and this is quite a whole new experience for me, being on board this boat. Fair executive, she's a bit of a sedan style boat, so I'm not quite sure how it'll work, but I think it's going to be good, Also not sure how the rivers are going to be. The rivers might be busy, they might be quiet. There was quite a number of people leaving Norfolk Broads Direct today, but there still seems to be quite a lot of their boats still in the boatyard. So it might be, there might be a few around, but I don't think it'll be too busy. I should get easily moored in all the popular places, so expecting to put on a few pounds by the end of the week. Anyway, I'm going to go away, get myself sorted, figure out what we're going to do, and kick back, relax, and enjoy the first day. So until later, I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now. Cheers. little wee update for you. I've had a think, and I think I know where I'm going to go. I'm going to try and get to some place that's going to be good food, good beer, and there's two possible places on the way down the river today, and that's either Ranworth for the maltsters or Ferndyke for the lion. Yeah, I could go down to Acle, but I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to be doing over the week. I've not really looked at the map, I've not got any ideas, so I think I'll hold off on going to Acle, because Acle's a good stopover point if I want to go south. So what I'm thinking is I'm going to head for Ferndyke and the lion. I'm going to go and eat in the lion tonight, because last time I was down, I left it a wee bit too late to go to the lion. I was way too stuffed. I'd overeaten and overdrank for the holiday, but I was just, you know, I couldn't really appreciate the fine food and the fine beer as much as I would usually enjoy. So tonight, I'm going to do it first night. There should be plenty of spaces. There is a few hire craft out and about, a few day boats out and about, the tour boats are out and about as well, but it's not actually that busy. So I'm thinking Ferndyke, there'll be plenty of space available by the time we get there. I'm just approaching Horning right now, so I'm kind of thinking it should only be a couple of hours to get down to Ferndyke from Horning. Give or take. I'm just taking a nice, sedate, relaxed cruise, and it's wonderful. So yeah, that's where the night's destination is going for today. And it's a bit of a shame that the sun's not out and about. It's been quite cloudy, overcast, but it's still not actually too cold, you know, just on the nippy side of mild. Yes, lovely. So that's where we're going. So as always, I will keep you updated. Until later, I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now. Cheers. just a little wee update for you. I'm here at Fern Dyke, and right down there, the lion. Excellent. Oh, I'm really looking forward to it. I've been dying to get down there and sample there. Fantastic. I have no idea what is available. I'm kind of hoping they've got the whiskey cask cider on tonight. Maybe even that very unusual strawberry milkshake beer that I missed out on last time. I don't know. But yes, this is at Fern Dyke. I'm quite surprised. Nice wee gentle cruise down there. Only took me a couple of hours, so it was like brilliant. Unfortunately, the weather is going to be, yeah, not the best. It's really, really bitterly cold out there now. Not much of a wind. It's a light breeze, but it's starting that fine, drizzly, horrible, gets rain that really soaks you to the skin. So yeah, it doesn't look like it's going to be very nice at all. But the heating is on and it's lovely and toasty inside the boat. And I've got to say, I'm loving this boat. It's really, really comfortable. Quite a number of hire craft out and about. There's actually, while we're down here, there's even more hire craft coming in from Potterheim. Obviously, there are a number of the Herbert Woods boats. No idea what time they start serving dinner, but it looks like Fern Dyke is about to get very, very busy indeed. But that's okay. I have learned lessons from last time, and I've moored a wee bit further up the dyke. So if anybody moors on the other side of me, I should still be able to get out in the morning if I require it. I am looking forward to going out and spending an enjoyable evening. And I know not a lot has been happening today. It's just the weather's not really been conducive to pretty footage. First day of the holidays, you know, I don't know, I think it could be quite a sort of a sedate cruise adventure this week. Just getting back into a swing of things, you know. We'll wait and see what happens. We'll wait and see. Anyway, I'm not going to babble too much. I'm trying to limit my babbling. So I will say that might be the end of day one of the Great Norfolk Broads Adventure 7. I might be back later. If not, thank you for watching. But if I am back later, well, I'm quite sure you'll know all about it later. So that's all for today. Hope you've enjoyed it. Not been a lot going on. I know it's always just the first day. It's always a bit quiet and what have you. So until later. I might speak to you soon. I might not. But until later. Bye for now. Cheers. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube land. How are you doing this evening? Welcome once more to the wonderful delight of cider-infused dark side. Oh my goodness. Oh man. You know, I could tell you a lot, okay, about what I was drinking tonight and what I was eating tonight, but to tell you the truth, I can't, because I'm fucking rat-assed. Well, honestly, I can't tell you much at all about tonight. All I can say is that, once again, the lion has absolutely nailed it. Absolutely 100%. And it's just further goes to show exactly why, and I don't know if I've mentioned this, okay, but I'll mention this to you just now, that the lion at Fern Dyke recently was awarded the best pub award in like the country. Oh well, it might not have been the country, it might have been like East Anglia or the south of England, or you know, hey, it doesn't really matter, okay, because they've won the best fucking pub award, okay? And I've been saying for a couple of years now, by the way, okay, that the Lion is a seriously good place, okay? Now, the fact that they've won the best pub award, okay, a camera, and I will find out the exact award. In fact, I'm probably pretty sure that right now, I will have already posted the award on to the vlog, just to show you, so you can see, because I can't mind exactly what it is just now, because my brain's just so bloody infused, right? But it's a very difficult to win award, okay? And the fact that they've won it, okay, just goes to show how fantastic that place is. And I've been saying for a long time now, for the last 2 years, just how brilliant it was. I officially declared it my favourite place last year, okay? And now it has been officially recognised as the best place to go. Okay, so yeah, the Lion at Thorndyke, fantastic place. Are you seeing this, by the way? They're sitting on bloody water canisters. That's something you don't see every day. Oh my goodness. So yeah, anyway, the Lion, fantastic place, right? And I was drinking the cider, and once again, the ciders were unbelievable. I had, what did I have? I had a strawberry and rhubarb cider. I had a pink grapefruit and something else cider, which was really interesting. And I had a strong perry, which was really nice, and I had some sort of cloudy cider, you know, which was quite nice, but I'm not so sure. But yeah, I've been drinking cider tonight, and me, he just bloody fleeing. I'm just trying to think. I had pork. With mash and a cider sauce and some it was like sprinkled with black pudding, and oh man, it was gorgeous. It was absolutely unbelievably fantastic, you know, and oh, it's astounding. I'm feeling a wee bit worse for wear though, okay, but hey, you seeing this though, you know? This is something totally new, you know. Look at these patio doors looking right out, you know. Oh, obviously I'm looking into a boat behind me, but you know, fantastic view, isn't it? And it's not actually gotten that cold either. The temperature has warmed up a bit, or the cider has desensitized me to the cold, because I'm not feeling very cold. Although I have put the heating on, because I think I'm about ready to pass out. But that's besides the point. Besides the point is that I've really enjoyed my day. Now, I know it's not been a great deal happening today, and it's just been sort of, you know, the weather's been a bit miserable and a bit there, you know, and I've just been getting into a swing of things again, you know. And to tell you the truth, I've just been sort of so happy to be back on the Broads. Everything's just been, it just feels like I've been slowing down a wee bit, you know. I'm really pushing the boat out, so to speak, if you'll pardon the pun, on this boat, you know. And it just I'm just really enjoying being away, you know, on such a fantastic little vessel, you know. Something so comfortable, so luxurious, so premium, even, you know. I mean, it really is, you know. Anyway, I'm babbling, so I'm not going to talk too much. I'm determined on this adventure not to ramble too much, not to talk too much. So that's all I'm going to say. I've had a brilliant dinner. I've had a good few beers. I'm sorry if it's been a wee bit sort of dull on this adventure so far on day one, but it's just been so, just so peaceful, you know, and it's difficult to convey, you know, just how relaxing it is, you know, and how wonderful it has been. So yeah, that's all I'm going to say tonight. I'm going to call it a night tonight at that, and go away, take the shoes off. Considering how much glass there is, I may even have to close the curtains, because there's just maybe just a little bit too much glass for my bulbous naked body to be walking around on view. that's information you don't want to know. Anyway, right, okay, I'm gonna go there now. So if you have been watching, thank you. I hope you join me in day two. I'm quite sure, I've no idea where I'm gonna go. I've still not decided where I'm gonna go. I've literally, you know, not a clue. So we'll just see how things go. So please join me in day two. We'll see where we end up. We'll see what we do. I think it's gonna be one of those adventures of having absolutely no idea. So join me on this completely clueless adventure and see what happens. So until tomorrow, thanks for watching. It's been good to have your company, and I look forward to having you along with me on day two of the Great Norfolk Broads Adventure 7. So until then, bye for now. Cheers!